Welcome to ChemSimplified. I'm Dr. K, and in this video, we are going to balance chemical equation in four steps using the algebraic method. Generally, there are three methods to balance equations. The first method is through inspection, where you keep track of the number of atoms in your head, and you just keep adding them up as you go. The second method is quite similar to the first, except you write them down, making it easier to keep track. The third method, which is the method we are going to use today, is the algebraic method. It's best to use when you're trying to balance complex equations. I'll share the link to the second method in the description box below. So before we begin, let's go through a few basics. The whole idea of balancing equation is so that the number of each type of atoms are the same on both sides of the equation. When trying to balance the equation, we will not be allowed to change the chemical formula. If we end up with fractions or decimals in one or few of the terms, we'll need to multiply the smallest number to get whole number. Now that we've got our basics down, let's start with the first step. The first step is to write in the coefficients in front of each term. You can use any letters you wish, but I'll just start with A and work my way through to E. Next, we will form algebraic equations for each of the elements. So let's start with carbon. On the left-hand side, we have C6H5F. So that means we have 6 carbon. But because we have A in front of that term, we'll need to multiply 6 with A and write 6A for the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, there's only 1 carbon. So multiply that with the coefficient C, we have 1C. Therefore, the equation for carbon is 6A is equals to C. Now we move on to hydrogen. On the left-hand side, we have 5 hydrogen, so 5 multiplied with A will give us 5A. On the right-hand side, we have 2H. So 2 multiplied with D will give us 2D. The second equation we have formed is 5A is equals to 2D. Next, for fluorine. There's only 1F on the left, multiply with A, that gives us 1A. On the right hand side, there are 2F, multiply with E and it will give us 2E. Our third equation is going to be A is equals to 2E. Last but not least, for oxygen, we have 2 on the left, multiply with B gives us 2B. On the right side, we have oxygen on both CO and H2O terms. So we'll need to add them up. Let's start with CO. We have 1 oxygen, multiply with C gives us 1C. For the H2O term, there's also 1 oxygen, so multiply 1 with D, that will give us 1D. Therefore, we have C plus D on the right hand side, giving us the last equation, 2B is equals to C plus D. We now have 4 equations which we can use to solve for the value of A to E. So in order to solve the equations, we'll need to make an assumption. Usually, I just start by assuming one of the coefficients is equals to 1, since 1 is the smallest positive integer. So let's start with A is equals to 1. We'll start with the first equation, 6A is equals to C. So after substituting in 1 for A, we get C is equals to 6. So now we know the value of A and C. Let's continue with the second equation. 5A is equals to 2D. Let's substitute in 1 for A. So we have 5 times 1 equals 2D. And that gives us D is equals to 5 over 2. Even though 5 over 2 is a fraction, let's not worry about it right now. Next, we'll solve the third equation. Subbing in A is equals to 1, that will give us E is equals to 1 over 2. We're almost done, only one final equation left, and then we can find a value for B. So using the values for C and D that we have found, B turns out to be 17 over 4. So the final step is we'll need to substitute in the values that we have found for A to E. If there is no fraction or decimal, we're considered done. But since we have a bunch of fractions, we'll need to multiply the entire equation with the smallest number that will produce a whole number for every term. So let's consider the possibilities. If we multiply all terms with 2, we will get 2 in front of C6H5F, 17 over 2 for O2, 12 for CO, 5 for H2O, and 1 for F2. Well, that's not good because we are still left with one fraction for O2. So let's try to multiply with 4 instead. If we do that, we'll get 4,
17,
24, 10, and 2. That's great because we don't have any more fractions. So the trick is to multiply across the entire equation with the lowest common denominator. So we'll get the lowest set of whole number for all the terms. That being said, we did not consider 3 because it would still leave us with fractions. So here's our final answer after multiplying with 4. Let's recap on the steps we went through. We first write in our coefficients in front of each term. Then we form equations for each element. Then we make assumption and started solving the equations. Once we got the values, we plug them in. We'll need to multiply across to remove fractions if necessary. Please subscribe if you find this video helpful and click on that bell icon so you'll get notified on new videos. For more info or practice questions, please head over to ChemSimplified.com. You will find blog posts related to the video and some practice questions to test your skills. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.